The country that you all hate, but I love it. France. The year is 1896. The Cro-Magnon 1 fossil is found at the rock shelter site at Cro-Magnon, near the village of Les Aisies, France. The skull was the first example of who the first anatomically modern humans were in Europe. They lived during the Upper Paleolithic period. The Cro-Magnons, or early European modern humans, have evolved in Africa about 120,000 years ago and spread to Western Asia by 90,000 to 100,000 years ago. These people lived during the same times as Neanderthals did. European Cro-Magnon people became widespread during the Upper Paleolithic about 30 to 35,000 years ago. The Cro-Magnons were tall for the time, compared to their Neanderthal kin, of course, at a height about 5'5 and 5'7. They were very robust and freaking yiggity jiggity packed to the max! Their forehead was straight, with slight brow ridges, and the face was short and wide. Cro-Magnons were the first humans to have a prominent chin. It'd be interesting to see how the Black Pill folks would rate them. So looksmax.org, do your job. Eventually, these folks led to the creation of the cultures such as the Aurig Nation, Epigravidian, and Magdalenian. The Cro-Magnons identified prey feeding patterns to improve hunting success based on the season. In some seasons, larger animals like red deer, horses, and ibex would gather in groups, while reindeer would be unsuitable for hide protection due to insects. They even hunted based on migration patterns and sometimes took down woolly fucking mammoths. It did fish at times, but fishing became more common during the mid-upper Paleolithic. Magdalenian culture relied more on plant resources, aquatic resources, and small game, while the Epigravidian Chads were focused on hunting large game, like bison or horse. Humans probably played a major role in the extinction of megafauna in Europe, so that's sad. Their weapons were so rad. They had these crazy looking butt ends, and like, their weapons were so much cooler than like the vast majority of whatever the hell hunter-gatherers had. It was just, rock spear. The Cro-Magnon societies were nomadic, and their housing structures reflected this lifestyle. They constructed temporary shelters using available resources, such as animal hides and branches and other natural materials. These shelters were easy to assemble and disassemble, which was good to migrate whether the seasons were bad or good, and, you know, nomads. These G's, these fucking top G's, domesticated dogs. They made them split from wolves and they used them for hunting and shit. The Cro-Magnon were well known for their genuinely beautiful cave paintings. This shows the creativity and visualization of these people. It basically says a lot about who we are as humans. Art isn't just limited to animals and humans hunting, etc. They had portable art too. It's a mystery what they truly represent. Archaeologists will just say, the same BS.
My ritual!
Personally, I think it's just the symbol of fertility, and that's it. Now, the reason they're so chunky is probably them retaining their old features like steatopygia. Go watch my Hoisan video if you want to learn what that is. It's when women store a very, very, very significant amount of fat in their buttocks region. Made these other baton-like thingies, made of stone, horn, and, bone. Stop. You guys are so dirty-minded, you dirty-minded bastards. The purpose of these batons are unclear. They could have been used as dildos, currency, drumsticks, status symbolism, spears, the thing that holds tents, etc. Also, they have these animal figures, which were perhaps toys? Or they just made them because they were bored. I don't know. Or maybe they were just symbolic for rituals, I don't know. Like many people today, they loved accessories. Necklaces made out of animal teeth, ivory, and shells. Pendants, too. Prior to them lived the Neanderthals in Europe. The shorter, more thicker humans. Barely any evidence of them ever interbreeding, it was like sibling rivalry. mtDNA analysis done in 2004 shows that there's no evidence to support that the Cro-Magnon Homo sapiens wanted to interbreed with those huge-browed women. The decline of Neanderthals correlated a lot with Homo sapien expansion. Climate change did not lead to their extinction. We did. It's highly improbable that when modern humans encountered Neanderthals, they simply chose to coexist peacefully. As human populations grew, they need more land to ensure an adequate food supply for their offspring. Moreover, adopting an aggressive military strategy was also advantageous from an evolutionary standpoint. Since the Homo sapiens had longer limbs, they probably just used like a long-distance strategy to just get rid of them. i.e. the Neanderthals, while the Neanderthals, since they were like so stocky, would be a giant threat in close range distances. So the Homo sapiens had to like keep them at a distance, and that's how they won. All of this is reflected in boxing. The longest war to ever take place in human history was between Neanderthals and Homo sapiens, and it took 150,000 years.